welcome to day 4 of the sourdough bread starter series put together by the Kneady Homesteaders channel, Heather. Like I said before in the other videos, we'll put her link in the description box. And we are here to see what Gladys has done overnight. I have no idea. Caitlin did look, but she refuses to tell me.
Nope.
It's gotta be a surprise. So in this video, we might be doing another step, which is removing some of the starter and putting it in a new jar and discarding the rest. I haven't done that yet, and I don't know if I should have been, but I mean, the starter's looking great. So we're gonna do that, and we'll see. Let's see what Gladys is doing. Okay, took Gladys out of the oven. I'm nervous. All right, let's see what Gladys has done. If any of you have seen the videos prior to this one, you may remember what Gladys looked like last night. I haven't put a rubber band around here yet. Maybe I'll start doing that.
Put a rubber band around the jar?
Yeah, where the level, what, like some people did it from the beginning, and then
you can mark it?
Mm-hmm. But I haven't done that. Also, you might notice she's still in the same jar. I did not get a new jar yet. When I watched Heather's video today, I'm like realizing that I need to transfer some of the starter or discard some of the starter and put it into another jar. I do have this other jar here that another one I got for Christmas this year. This was the year for getting pretty jars. This had like one of those cookie mixes in it. So it'll work good. So I'm gonna have to transfer some into that jar.
Would it bother it by having that different type of lid, like the suction lid?
I'm not gonna seal it down. I'm just gonna throw the towel over the top.
Okay.
Okay, let's see. Well, I'm gonna see now, and my blind friends who are listening to this are gonna find out what Gladys has done. Here goes the lid. I hope she grew. Caitlin knows, but she's not saying.
I'm not gonna say it.
Lid is off.
Look inside.
Ooh. I'm going to smell it first. It is heavier.
Oh, good grief. Good golly, Miss Molly. Okay.
Woo! Alrighty. I'm going to assume she grew.
She's definitely doing good. Oh, that was me.
Oh, yeah. It feels thick, you know, like it's got more body to it, but not like super thick. It's just nice.
And
it goes right through.
It has what you want, bubbles and dark liquid.
Oh, I hope I didn't just break them up, because we need to get a picture of that.
Oh, the bubbles?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, anyway.
So, Caitlin can see, so she's going to describe to my friends who are visually impaired or blind what is happening in this jar.
So, Gladys has definitely grown. She has the, we said in the last video that she is supposed to have dark colored liquid. And when you look at the side of the jar, you can see of the level of dark liquid on the top. And then when you look inside of the jar, from the top, there is bubbles, which is also what you need. And what does Gladys feel like when you poke her?
She's real smooth. It's not hard to put the...
Is she like thick?
Thick, but nice. Like not like a tough kind of thick.
Mm-hmm.
It's real nice. Like a nice batter feel to it.
Yeah. So how does it...
And a very strong odor.
What's the dark liquid on the top?
It's alcohol. It's fermenting.
Oh,
mm-hmm.
That makes sense.
Okay. It's doing what it's supposed to.
Yes, it is. It definitely
is. Oh, my goodness. Okay, so what we're going to do is stir it up. So here I go.
You were really worried at first about it not turning out. And then,
oh, because I've heard a lot of times it's hard, but this isn't.
Because our oven, at first, remember we put it on proof instead of the light?
Mm-hmm.
And it would turn itself off in the middle of the night if it was on too long.
Mm-hmm.
So that's probably part of the reason why you're worried is because the oven wasn't, Gladys wasn't in the
Yes, the inside of the oven was kind of cold.
Yeah.
but we've kept the light on now and it's so warm, so I think it's true that the warmth helps it ferment and grow.
And it doesn't
feel lumpy. Like, I don't know if it looks lumpy, but it does not feel lumpy.
No, it doesn't.
It's very smooth.
Move your hand real quick. No. It looks cool.
See, when I stir it, it's just smooth, like pancake batter. Like,
yeah. It's not really like yesterday.
Okay, so now what I need to do is pour some of this out. If you're doing grams, milligrams, I think. Anyway, I don't have a scale, like I said. Those of you who don't know, I am totally blind. They do make talking scales, but I don't have one. So now I need to pour out 2/3 cup of this mixture and pour it into a new jar. And then add...
this one.
Yeah, this jar. It's a nice big jar. And then add 2/3 cup wheat flour and 2/3 cup lukewarm filtered water.
It looks so clean compared to the other jar.
And I am nervous about this because one of my viewers pointed out that I'm not using a funnel, which she's right. I don't have the wide mouth funnels and I really wish I did. I've got to put that on my list to get. I know they're inexpensive. I just, every time I'm anywhere that would have them, I forget. I don't even think about it.
We have a funnel, but it's like tiny.
Yeah, I don't think that one would work. So I have to try to put some of this into a measuring cup and then pour it into a new jar. Challenge. This is a challenge for me. I'm sure it's a challenge for anyone, sighted or not, but being blind, this is going to be a little bit of a challenge. So let me go get the water ready and we'll be right back. Okay, so what just happened was the whole clip that we just did of me switching the batter into this jar and the way I did it, the whole clip was messed up. It didn't record. So that's okay because I'm probably going to have to do it again tomorrow the same way. So let me just show you guys in my new jar here. I transferred 2/3 cup of the
Gladys,
the starter to this new jar. And then I added the 2/3 cup water and the 2/3 cup flour, stirred it really well. And here's all my dirty dishes to prove that I did that. It was a big old mess and the clip didn't work. It happens. Yeah. Those of you who do videos, you know it happens. So that's okay. I'll show you next time. Anyway, good night to Gladys. I'm going to have to stick a bowl upside down on top of this lid because I'm not going to clasp it shut and it wants to pop open. So we are going to...
Get Gladys's
and a bowl.
Wait, that's her blanket. That's her pillow.
I don't know if that's the right way or not, but.
Nope.
No, right. Oh, great. All right. Good night, Gladys. Thank you, everybody, for watching us do this. It's very exciting. I think the part cut out where I said, learning to do this hands-on is the best way. I mean, that's just the best way to learn, I feel, is to do it, try it, and learn from it. And you know next time what you would do differently and all of that. So anyway, good night, and we will see you tomorrow night.